ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम गणानां त्वा गणपतिगुं हवामहे कविं कवि ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पत आनश्वं वन्मोतिभिस्सीद सादनं श्री महागणाधिपतये नमः सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् ओं सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै द्विषावहै ओं शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः दि मंत्र पोर्शन एषत आत्मा सर्वांतरः भाष्यकार एषः कोसौ तव आत्मा सो तव मीन्स कार्यकरण संघातस्य तव आत्मा स्वरूपम् सो आई एम टॉकिंग ऑफ नॉट यू because you are the one who is identified with the body mind, the conglomerate of body mind and senses, so you take that to be yourself, but your swarupa means essential nature is atma, and that atma is sarvantaraha, it is antara abhyantara, innermost to all these outer covers, koshas. योऽयं कार्यकरण संघातस्तव येन आत्मना आत्मवान् स एष तव आत्मा. यू सी दिस वाक्य हैज टू बी करेक्टली अंडरस्टूड. येन देहः आत्मवान् सः आत्मा. देह इज देयर बॉडी. दि बॉडी इज आत्मवान्. दि बॉडी हैज आत्मा. आत्मवान् मीन्स व्हाट? आत्मा अस्ति आत्मवान्. Body has atma. Body has atma means body has bodiness. That is the atma. Body has bodiness. Bodiness means what? It is an existence and it is a satta and sphurti. It exists and it shines. Right? To say body, body should exist. It is not enough that it exists. It should exist and shine. Then you can call it body, right? So, suppose something doesn't exist and doesn't shine. Can you call it anything? No. So the body exists and shines and then we call it body. Okay. But it appears like that. Really, even when body exists, it exists in the being. And even when it shines in the being. Therefore, even as it appears to exist as body and appears to shine as body, it is indeed existing as the being and shining as the being. So, these are the two things. So, sometimes I tend to make it a little complicated also. So, possible. But let me put it slightly differently. So, there is a thing called satta. Existence and spurti shining. So everything that appears has a satta and a shining. And this satta of the body and the shining of the body are not real, are not their own, are not the body's own. It is the shining of the atma, it is the being of the atma which is now taken as the body. That is how it is. Somebody said, necklace is shining. Okay? That example will make it more clear. When you say necklace is shining, that is and shining, do they belong to gold or do they belong to a thing called necklace? They belong to gold. It is really the gold which is shining. And but we take it as necklace is shining. The easiness of necklace is the easiness of gold. And the shining of the necklace is the shining of the gold. Similarly, When you say body, the easiness of the body and the shining of the body is nothing more than Atma. Therefore, Satta Sphurti of the body are indeed Satta Sphurti of the Atma alone. And so that Satta Sphurti, which are very basic things of the body, so they are the Atma. Therefore, look at the body and understand the being of the body is Atma. The shining of the body is Atma. Then what is the body now? It is only Nama Rupa. It's a name and form, it's an appearance. Anyway, so that is how you have to understand. That's why ultimately you should appreciate it like this. When you say body, you should not take it that body is a thing. Body is not a thing. Body is not real. It is not a thing. It is an idea in the mind. Body is an idea in the mind. So that's why without the sense of touch, there will be no sense of the body at all. And without the mind, there will be no sense of the touch also. Because it is the mind which appreciates the sense of touch. Therefore, body is an idea in the mind, and mind is a movement in Atma. Now, what is body? Atma. So, that is how you have to understand. Tatra pindaha tasya abhyantare lingatma karana sanghataha trutiyo yascha sandihyamanaha teshu katamaha mamatma sarvantaraha tvaya vivakshitaha ityuktaha itara aha. These are some of the things that are difficult to explain. Anyway, you see the vakya, the mantra, eshata atma sarvantaraha, that is the reply given by Yajnavalkya. Now, again, he is asking a question. You may look at the mantra vakya, katamo yajnavalkya sarvantaraha. That is the question again. And the answer is yav pranena praniti is the answer. So, hey, Yajnavalkya, you said Atma sarvantaraha, Atma is the innermost of all. Which one? Katamaha. Sarvantaraha, the innermost of all Atma, katamaha. Which one? Generally, when there are two things and you want to ask which one, so you use kataraha, tara. When there are more than two things, namely, minimum three things must be there, and you want to ask which one, then you have to use katamaha. These are two pratyayas, datarach and datamach. That die is a, to make it dit. So, dakara itsaunya. There is an advantage in that. So, katara, which among the two? Katama, which among the many? Many means at least three. So, you say, innermost of all, sarvantarha, which among, which one? Means at least three things should be in the mind. And referring to those three things, he should ask as katamaha. So, Bhashyakara has explained those three things. You see, okay, tatra means when you consider sarva, sarvantaraha atma. So take that sarva into account all. In that all, it begins with pindaha. In that all, tatra, pindaha. Pindaha is the physical body. Okay. Then you go one more step. Inner, it's a travel to the inner. Tasya abhyantare lingatma karana sanghataha. So go one step inner. Abhyantare, as you travel inner, travel inner means you look through. So just don't get stuck at the level of the body. So body exists బికాస్ ఆఫ్ ది లింగ శరీర. వితౌట్ లింగ శరీర స్థూల శరీర కెనాట్ ఎగ్జిస్ట్. వితౌట్ లింగ శరీర స్థూల శరీర కెనాట్ షైన్. దిస్ ఈజ్ వాట్ ఐ వాజ్ స్ట్రగ్లింగ్ టు ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్. నౌ వెన్ ది మైండ్ ఈజ్ నాట్ దేర్, మీన్స్ వెన్ ది మూమెంట్ ఆఫ్ మైండ్ ఈజ్ అబ్సెంట్, డూ యూ హ్యావ్ ఎ బాడీ? జస్ట్ థింక్ ఆఫ్ ఇట్. యూ హ్యావ్ ఎ బాడీ? యు సే నో. యూ హ్యావ్ టు సే నో. ఇఫ్ యూ డోంట్ సే నో, దెన్ ఐ కెనాట్ మేక్ ఎనీ ఫర్దర్ ప్రోగ్రెస్. Because people say, yeah, I have the body. My wife told me that I was like that. You should not answer like that. That is not the answer expected. So when you are, from your point of view, you have to tell. So the wife, shelling, everything came later only, you know, when the mind is moving. So I am asking about the mind's absence. When the mind is absent, so don't bring anything which is there in the mind's movement stage. Don't bring anything into it. Without bringing anything from the waking state, you answer the question. When the mind is not moving, do you have a body?
No.
No. Now where is the body now? Is it in the mind? And now one more question. When the mind starts moving, you have a body. Yes or no?
Yes.
Now you tell me, where is the body? Is it in the mind or elsewhere? It is in the mind. So if body is in the mind, then what is this body? What it will be? Thought. That's it. Because whatever is in the mind is a thought, I say. Idea. Hey, you sit there only and you answer all my questions. Because body is an idea in the mind. The mind should start moving. And in the process of its movement, it recognizes the shape called body because of the sense of touch, mainly. Even if you close the eyes, the body sense is there, you know. That's why sense of touch. So mainly, therefore, body is an idea in the mind. Therefore, when you go from body to mind, now you are in the mind. Now what happened to the body? Is it left behind or is it resolved in the mind? It is resolved in the mind. It is not left behind. It is like shadow. Body is a shadow of the mind. That is how you have to go in there. Therefore, that is the abhyantara. Abhyantare lingatma. Lingatma is the sukshma sharira. Everything is atma. So, sukshma sharira. So, another name for it is karana sanghataha. It is the conglomerate. Even the mind is the conglomerate of karanas, sense organs. So, what is mind? So, mind is the knowledge of forms, the knowledge of sounds, all these put together becomes mind. And all thoughts have their basis in the perception only. Whatever you think, only what you perceived, only you think. All feelings have their basis in perception. And therefore, anumana means inference, has its basis in perception. Therefore, the mind itself is nothing but a conglomerate of the five senses. Karana Sanghataha. Okay. That is the second. Now you have to find out three. Then Katamaha can be answered. What is the third? Trutiyaha Yascha Sandihyamanaha. So the third. The third is the Sakshi. What is behind the Sukshma Sharira? That is the mind. That is the Sakshi. The knower behind the thinker. That is the Sakshi. These three are very well recognized even by the questioner, Ushastha. He clearly recognized these three. And so in the context of that recognition, he is telling, so sarva, antara, innermost of all means which innermost? So is it, these three are there, which is the innermost? Because the question is very relevant. Because the Charvakas will say, among these three, body is the Atma. That is the Atma. Then what about mind? Mind is epiphenomenon of the body. And what about Sakshi? That is also a phenomenon or a part of the mind alone. Now everything is resolved in body now. Therefore body is Atma. This is how the Charvaka or the Shunyavadi talks about it. We mentioned that also, you know. On the other hand, Vedanta goes the other way. Body is a phenomenon in the mind. and mind is a phenomenon in the Atma Chaitanya. And Atma Chaitanya in the context of an Upadhi appears as the Sakshi. Therefore, that Sakshi, you arrive at it. You cannot talk of Atma Chaitanya in absolute terms. So only in that also will come now. So with reference to Upadhi only we can talk about it. So in the context of the Upadhi, Upadhi means the medium. So in the context of the medium, you have the third as the Sakshi. So in these three, which is the one that you are pointing out as Sarvantara? Katamaha Yajnavalkya. Sandihyamanaha. Is it the body? Or is it the Sukshma Sharira? Or is it the Sakshi? That is the Sandeha. That is the doubt. And so having that kind of a doubt in mind, Ushastaha, so he is asking, Teshu Katamaha Mama Atma Sarvantarastvaya Vivakshitaha. You are again and again saying Sarvantaraha, Sarvantaraha, innermost of all. So what is it that you are pointing out? What is your intent? Vivakshitaha. When you say Sarvantaraha, what is your intent? Among these three, which is my Atma? Of course I know that when I say me, it is the Karyakarana Sanghata that I am talking about. But now I am asking, these three are clearly visible, are clearly appreciated in the context of this Upadhi, and which one is the Atma that you are pointing out as Sarvantara? That is the question. Ityuktaha itara aha. When Ushastha has asked like this, the other one, itaraha means the other, that is Yajnavalkya, is replying. Now you look at the mantra. Yah pranena praniti sata atma sarvantaraha yopanena apaniti sata atma sarvantaraha yo vyanena vyaniti sata atma sarvantaraha య ఉదానేనోదానితి సత ఆత్మా సర్వాంతరః ఏషత ఆత్మా సర్వాంతరః తే ఆఫ్ యు ఆఫ్ యు మీన్స్ ది సంఘాత ది కాంప్లెక్స్ సో ఆఫ్ యు means of me, it becomes of me, the Sanghata. So, the Atma, the Sara, the Sanghata is there. What is its Sara essence? What is its reality? What is its essential content? That content is Atma. And even as the essence of the whole Sanghata, it is Sarvantara. How to arrive at it? So, you arrive at it as Sarvantara, the innermost of all. Eshata Atma Sarvantaraha. That alone is further and further explained through a few examples. The first example is, Yah pranena praniti saha te Atma Sarvantaraha. You want to know Atma. I say that Atma is Sarvantara. So, you want to know what is Sarvantara. Okay. There is prana. Means expulsion of air is prana. The act of expelling is there, praniti. Praniti is like verb it is. Prana cheshtang karoti ityarthaha. So, the act of expelling is doing. The upadhi is doing the act of expelling. So, praniti, it is, the words are carefully appreciated. That's why I repeat. So, prana cheshtang karoti. Cheshta is there. An action is, a faculty, a function is there. So the expelling as a function, it is happening. And so it is happening by a vital force. There must be a vital force, you know. Without the vital force, how it will happen? So the name of that vital force is prana. Therefore, how the expelling happens through the vital force called prana, it is happening. Okay? And now this Atma alone is causing this action of expulsion. Through the vital force called prana, that is Atma. Therefore, now what is the definition of Atma? Atma is that which makes the act of expulsion possible through the vital force called prana. Yah pranena praniti saha atma. Okay? And that atma, again, once again, he doesn't say what is atma in so many words. He points out to atma only. Okay? There is expulsion. You examine it. This is pranayama. There are two kinds of pranayamas. Murkha pranayama, buddhimat pranayama. Really? Really? Murkha yogi, buddhimat yogi, the two yogis are there. Yoginam dhematam, that is what Bhagavan says. You should not only be a yogi, you should be a buddhiman yogi. Yoginam dhematam, like that he says. So, athava yoginam eva kule bhavati dhematam. He takes birth in yogi's family. But then there is an adjective to that yogi. Dhematam yoginam. So those yogis who are having knowledge, that means the morkha yogis also must be there. Then only visheshanam becomes meaningful. Visheshanam vyavartakam. It distinguishes one from the other. Morkha yogi. Morkha yogi means he only knows how to bend the limbs. Nothing more than that. And he knows how to inhale and exhale. Nothing more than that. You should not stop there. So, that's why pranayama is a physical exercise. You should not forget that fact. It is a physical exercise. Because inhale, exhale is physical thing it is. Only thing is very fine. It is not as physical as the physical body, but it is intermediary between body and mind. Therefore, it is very much finer. And so, when you observe the prana, through prana, you can go to the sarvantara. The truth you can reach. That is the purpose of observing the prana. That's why there is a thing called prana vikshanam. There is a thing called pranayama. And also prana vikshanam. In prana vikshanam, we don't apply any of our willpower to that. Only in pranayama there is will to do it in a particular way. So you observe the expulsion. Just be a neutral observer. Observe the expulsion. It is happening by a vital force. There is a vital force here. And because of which it is happening. The lungs, they throw it out. The air is thrown out by the lungs. It means the lungs are having vitality in them to throw out. That vitality is called prana. In fact, it is all one vitality. But we call it prana. It is like calling heat of electricity, cooler electricity, fan electricity, bulb electricity. That is how it is called. All one electricity. Of course, we know it is all one electricity. But we want to call it this way for a particular reason. So this is what is called pranapanam yanodana samana. So the prana, the vitality, that particular aspect of vital force which throws out. So then you mean to say, now the question is prana the ultimate? Is the vital force the ultimate? If the vital force is the ultimate, then vital force becomes atma. Right? In fact, there are people who say vital force is the atma. Dakshinamurti Stotram, you know that verse, Deham pranam apindriyanyapi chalam buddhinchi shunyam viduhu. Deha atmavadi, prana atmavadi is there. There is a prana atmavadi. We don't find him often. Because it is so obvious that prana is not atma. If I inhale and exhale, I am different from the process of inhalation and exhalation, you know, that is always obvious. So like body. Anyway, so there is something other than prana which inspires prana to do what it does. Yah pranena praniti. And that something which is making the act of expulsion possible through the vital force of prana is the atma which is the innermost of all. He usasta. That is how he replied. Bhashyakara. Yah pranena mukhanasika sancharina praniti. In fact, the Tikakara makes it very clear in the very beginning. The moment you say yaha pranena praniti. Praniti means karoti ityarthaha. సో యహ ప్రాణేన కరోతి హూ పెర్ఫార్మ్స్ త్రూ ప్రాణ. జస్ట్ బై లుకింగ్ ఎట్ దట్ వాక్య ఇట్ బికమ్స్ వెరీ క్లియర్ దట్ యహ ఈజ్ నాట్ సేమ్ యాజ్ ప్రాణ. రైట్? ఇఫ్ యహ ఈజ్ సేమ్ యాజ్ ప్రాణ, హౌ యూ మేక్ దట్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఎ సెంటెన్స్? ఐ ఆమ్ రైటింగ్ విత్ పెన్. సో ఎమ్ ఐ పెన్ ఆర్ ఎమ్ ఐ డిఫరెంట్ పెన్ ఫ్రమ్ పెన్? ఐ ఆమ్ డిఫరెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ పెన్ అయితే. సిమిలర్లీ యఫ్ ప్రాణేన ప్రాణితి మీన్స్ యహ ప్రాణభిన్న ప్రాణేన ప్రాణితి ప్రాణ విలక్షణ. సో ద వన్ విచ్ ఈస్ డిస్టింక్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ ప్రాణ, దట్ వన్, వాట్ ఎవర్ దట్ వన్, లెట్ అస్ కాల్ ఇట్ ఆత్మ. సో దట్ వన్ ఈజ్ మేకింగ్ ది యాక్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ప్రెషన్ పాసిబుల్ త్రూ దిస్ ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్ ఆర్ టూల్. వైటల్ ఫోర్స్ ఈస్ ది టూల్ కాల్డ్ ప్రాణ. యఫ్ ప్రాణేన ప్రాణితి దెన్ వాట్ ఈస్ దిస్ ప్రాణ? ప్రాణ ఈజ్ నథింగ్ బట్ ముఖనాశిక సంచారిణ. సో ది ప్రాణ ఈజ్ ది వైటల్ ఫోర్స్. సో దట్ మేక్స్ ది ఇన్హలేషన్ ది ఎక్సలేషన్ పార్ట్ అపానేనా ఇస్ దేర్ యునో. ప్రాణ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో ఏ వైటల్ ఫోర్స్ ఫంక్షనింగ్ ఇన్ ది ఏరియా ఆఫ్ మౌత్ అండ్ నోస్, ముఖనాశిక సంచారిణ. సో ది వైటల్ ఫోర్స్ ఇట్ ఎక్స్పెల్స్ ఫ్రమ్ వేర్? ఎక్స్పెల్స్ త్రూ ది లంగ్స్, దేర్ ఫోర్ ఇట్ ఈజ్ ఇన్ ది లంగ్స్. దెన్ ఇట్ ఎక్స్పెల్స్ త్రూ ది థ్రోట్, త్రూ ది మౌత్, ఆల్ త్రూ ఇట్ ఎక్స్పెల్స్. సో ప్రాణాపానౌ సమౌ కృత్వా నాసాభ్యంతరచారిణౌ, నాసా అభ్యంతర, నోస్ అండ్ ఇన్ సైడ్ ది నోస్, ముఖ. శంకర యాడెడ్ ముఖ ఆల్సో, ముఖ ఈజ్ మౌత్. సమ్టైమ్స్ యూ మే ఎక్స్పెల్ త్రూ ది మౌత్ ఆల్సో, నాట్ ఓన్లీ త్రూ నోస్, సమ్టైమ్స్ త్రూ మౌత్ ఆల్సో యూ ఎక్స్పెల్. సమ్టైమ్స్ యూ ఇన్హేల్ త్రూ మౌత్ ఆల్సో. Sometimes it happens, you know, when the nose is blocked, what to do? So, something you have to do. Anyway, so mukhanasika sancharana praniti means prana cheshtang karoti. Then you may ask, so atma is karta? Kya? This is not that topic. That way you should not confuse. This is what I mean. So the other day you told atma karta. Now you are telling Atma is expelling. So that way you should not confuse like that. So what is, because the topic is different, this topic is different. So if you confuse these two topics, then the effort to reach the source of everything fails and we will be caught in other discussions. So prana is not a swayam karta. It appears to be the karta. The action is that of prana, vital force. But because it is the Atma which is the ground of everything, even the action of the vital force appears to be the action of Atma. Therefore, in the presence of Atma alone, on the ground of being alone, prana is doing the act. But when the prana cheshta, the act of the vital force is superimposed on Atma, then Atma appears to be doing what the prana is doing. Because in the absence of Atma, nothing is done. Nothing is possible. Therefore, on the ground of Atma, the prana is making the expulsion of air possible. That being, see, first there is being, that is the Atma. Then there is knowing, that is the movement in Atma. And then there is doing, further gross movement in Atma. The movement is of two kinds, gross, subtle and gross. The knowing is the subtle movement and the doing is the gross movement. So here we are talking of doing. So the doing has its origin in the being. It is as though the being is making the doing possible. In fact, that is how it is. That is the Atma. Yena prana praniyate ityarthaha. You see, yena prana praniyate, very beautiful sentence of Bhashyakara. See, I tell you how. Expulsion is there. Now, expulsion is made possible all by itself, or is there a power behind that expulsion? There is a power behind it. And that power is called prana, the vital force, prana. Okay. And that prana, it is the power behind the expulsion. సో దిస్ ప్రాణ ఈజ్ ఇట్ ఇండిపెండెంట్ అండ్ సెల్ఫ్ సఫిషియంట్ ఇన్ ఇట్స్ ఫంక్షన్ ఆర్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ ఎ సోర్స్ ఫ్రమ్ విచ్ ఇట్ డిరైవ్స్ ఇట్స్ పవర్ దట్ ఈస్ ది క్వశ్చన్ ది ఆన్సర్ ఈజ్ ప్రాణ ఈజ్ నైదర్ ఇండిపెండెంట్ నార్ సెల్ఫ్ సఫిషియంట్ ఇన్ ఇట్స్ పవర్ ఆర్ ఇన్ ఇట్స్ ఫంక్షన్ ఇట్ డిరైవ్స్ ఇట్స్ ఎగ్జిస్టెన్స్ అండ్ ఇట్స్ పవర్ ఫ్రమ్ ఎ డిఫరెంట్ సోర్స్ విచ్ ఈజ్ ఆత్మ సో ఏన ప్రాణ ప్రణీయతే బై విచ్ ది పవర్ ప్రాణ ది వైటల్ ఫోర్స్ ప్రాణ ఈజ్ మేడ్ టు ఫంక్షన్ ఈజ్ మేడ్ క్యాపబుల్ ఆఫ్ ఫంక్షనింగ్ దట్ ఈజ్ ఆత్మ ఏన ప్రాణ ప్రణీయతే ప్రణీయతే మీన్స్ ప్రాణన విశిష్ట క్రియతే సో ప్రాణ ది వైటల్ ఫోర్స్ ప్రాణ ఈజ్ ఎక్విప్డ్ విత్ ఆర్ ఈజ్ ఎండౌడ్ విత్ ది పవర్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్పల్షన్ బై విచ్ ఆత్మ దట్ ఆత్మ ఈజ్ డిస్టింక్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ ది వైటల్ ఫోర్స్ ప్రాణ సో నౌ ది వైటల్ ఫోర్స్ ఈజ్ ది ఫింగర్ విచ్ పాయింట్స్ అవుట్ టు ది మూన్ ఆఫ్ ఆత్మ ఫింగర్ పాయింట్స్ టు ది మూన్ సో లుక్ ఎట్ ది వైటల్ ఫోర్స్ ప్రాణాపాన యూ విల్ రిజాల్వ్ ఇన్ ది బీయింగ్ యు నో హౌ ఇట్ హ్యాపెన్స్ ప్రాణ ది వైటల్ ఫోర్ ది ఇన్హలేషన్ ఎక్సలేషన్ ప్రాణాయామ ఇస్ దేర్ సో దిస్ ప్రాణాయామ ది రెస్పిరేషన్ ఇట్ ఆరిజినేట్స్ ఫ్రమ్ దట్ సోర్స్ ఫ్రమ్ విచ్ ది పవర్ ఆఫ్ నోయింగ్ ఆల్సో ఆరిజినేట్స్ దేర్ ఆర్ టూ పవర్స్ నౌ వన్ ఈస్ ది పవర్ ఆఫ్ నోయింగ్ అండ్ ది అదర్ ఈస్ ది పవర్ ఆఫ్ మూవింగ్ మూమెంట్ అండ్ సో బోత్ దీస్ పవర్స్ హ్యావ్ ది సేమ్ ఆరిజిన్ దట్ ఈస్ ది ఆత్మ దట్ ఈస్ ది సోర్స్ దేర్ఫోర్ యూ కెన్ రిజాల్వ్ వన్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ ఇన్ ది అదర్ అండ్ త్రూ దట్ యూ కెన్ రీచ్ ది సోర్స్ హౌ ఐ టెల్ యూ యూ వాచ్ ది మైండ్ దెన్ వెన్ యూ వాచ్ ది మైండ్ దెన్ ద మైండ్ రిజాల్వ్స్ వెన్ ది మైండ్ రిజాల్వ్స్ యూ గోయింగ్ టు ది సోర్స్ ఆఫ్ బీయింగ్ రైట్ ఆర్ యూ వాచ్ ది ప్రాణ దెన్ ద ప్రాణ రిజాల్వ్స్ అండ్ అగైన్ యూ రీచ్ ది సేమ్ సోర్స్ ద సోర్స్ ఆఫ్ బీయింగ్ వై సో బికాస్ దిస్ మనహ విచ్ ఈస్ ఎ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ మూమెంట్ వన్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ పవర్ అండ్ ప్రాణ అనదర్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ పవర్ బోత్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ హ్యావ్ ది సేమ్ ఆరిజిన్ విచ్ ఈస్ ద బీయింగ్ అండ్ దట్ బీయింగ్ ఈజ్ యూ దట్ ఈస్ ది ఆత్మ దేర్ఫోర్ ద మైండ్ బికమ్స్ ద ఫింగర్ దట్ లక్షణ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ద ఫింగర్ లక్షయతి ఇది లక్షణం ద ఫింగర్ దట్ పాయింట్స్ అవుట్ ద మూన్ ఆఫ్ ఆత్మ ద మైండ్ జనరలీ యూ నీడ్ నాట్ పాయింట్ అవుట్ సన్ ఓన్లీ యూ హ్యావ్ టు పాయింట్ అవుట్ మూన్ దట్స్ వై వీ యూజ్ ది వర్డ్ ఫింగర్ అండ్ మూన్ శాఖాచంద్ర న్యాయం సో సిమిలర్లీ ఎ థాట్ ఆల్సో కుడ్ బికమ్ ది పాయింటర్ టు ఆత్మ దేర్ఫోర్ ఐ టెల్ యూ యూ కెనాట్ పిన్ పాయింట్ ఆత్మ యూ కెనాట్ డిస్క్రైబ్ ఆత్మ యూ కెనాట్ గ్రాస్ప్ ఇట్ విత్ ఏదర్ లాంగ్వేజ్ ఆర్ మైండ్ యూ కెన్ ఓన్లీ సిగ్నల్ ఇట్ యూ దిస్ ఈజ్ ది సిగ్నల్ సో త్రూ ద ప్రాణ యూ కెన్ సిగ్నల్ ది ఆత్మ నౌ దిస్ ఇస్ ది లైన్ దిస్ ఇస్ ది డైరెక్షన్ యూ టేక్ యూ విల్ రీచ్ ఆత్మ దట్ వే ఓన్లీ ఇట్ కెన్ బి సెట్ శాస్త్ర పాయింట్స్ అవుట్ ఆర్ సిగ్నల్స్ ది ట్రూత్ ఇట్ డజంట్ టెల్ ది ట్రూత్ బికాస్ ట్రూత్ కెనాట్ బి టోల్డ్ అండ్ వాట్ ఈస్ టోల్డ్ కెనాట్ బి ట్రూత్ సతే తవ కార్యకరణ సంఘాతస్య ఆత్మా విజ్ఞానమయ వన్ వెరీ ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్ వాక్య సో సహా దాట్ విచ్ మేక్స్ ప్రాణ యాక్ట్ ఇన్ దిస్ పర్టికులర్ ఫ్యాషన్ దట్ ఈస్ ది ఆత్మ దట్ ఈస్ ది సారా ఎసెన్స్ రియాలిటీ ఆఫ్ యువర్ కంగ్లామరేట్ కార్యకరణ సంఘాత యూ టేక్ ది కార్యకరణ సంఘాత టు బి మీ సో దిస్ మీ విచ్ ఈస్ ది కార్యకరణ సంఘాత హ్యాజ్ ఇట్స్ బీయింగ్ ఇన్ దట్ ఆత్మ విచ్ యూ కెన్ రీచ్ త్రూ ది ఫంక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాణ అండ్ దట్ ఆత్మ ఇట్ ఈజ్ నాట్ ఓన్లీ ప్రాణ ఇట్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో విజ్ఞానమయ ఇట్ ఈజ్ నాట్ ఓన్లీ ప్రాణమయ మీన్స్ త్రూ ప్రాణ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఫంక్షనింగ్ దిస్ వే నాట్ ఓన్లీ దట్ సో ఇట్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో విజ్ఞానమయ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ అనదర్ స్ట్రీమ్ దేర్ ఆర్ టూ స్ట్రీమ్స్ ఆఫ్ పవర్ ఎమనేటింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ ది ఆత్మ వన్ ఈస్ ది ప్రాణ అనదర్ అదర్ ఈజ్ విజ్ఞానమయ మీన్స్ విజ్ఞాన ఆల్సో కుడ్ బి ఎ మూమెంట్ ఇన్ దట్ ఆత్మ అండ్ ఆత్మ reflects in that movement, jnanamayaha. So what happens is, prana is one upadhi in which atma is expressing now. That is pranena praniti. Vijnana becomes another upadhi. Vijnana means buddhi. Buddhi or manaha. So that becomes another upadhi. Maya means upadhi. Vijnanamayaha. Yaha pranamayaha saha vijnanamayaha. What is reflecting in prana, the same thing is reflecting in vijnana. Therefore, prana is one upadhi, vijnana is another upadhi. Like electricity. Electricity is reflecting in the fan as well as in the bulb. Bulb is shining, fan is moving. Electricity reflecting in both. In fact, this electricity example, Shankara points out, he gives that example. Very interesting. In the Bhashya, electricity means not electricity, something akin to that. Samana manyat. There are 3-4 vakyas, you know. Ya pranena praniti sata atma sarvantaraha. Yopanena paniti sata atma sarvantaraha. Esha atma sarvantaraha. Like that, 3-4 vakyas are there. All are similarly understood. So second vakya you see, yopanena apaniti yovyanena vyaniti iti chandasam dairghyam. You see, praniti, the verb is like that. There are certain verbs for which the lat ekavachanam is comes as iti. Ti is already there. Bhavati, karoti. That ti is already there. Ti is the pratyam. Yeah, so, tip. Tip tas ji, etc. Tip. So, the ti is there. In addition to that ti, one more e comes. Such dhatus are very characteristic dhatus. For example, swapiti, swapa. But when I let the ekavacharam, e comes. Swapiti. Then, praniti, e comes. Apaniti, e comes. So it should be e. Why apaniti, dirgham is there in the mantra? Okay, you got the point. Similarly, udaniti, e must be. It must be e. But dirgham is there. Udaniti. Why dirgham? It should be hraswam according to the vyakarana. You see, this person is a chandasa. Did you hear the word chandasa? Chandasa means he's very, very stingy about it. He won't leave it quickly. Chandasa. That's why instead of saying apaniti, he prolonged it. Apaniti, udaniti. Anyway, I tried to make a joke out of it. So chandasam dairjam means chandaha vedaha. The Vedic usage is like that. That dirgha, you need not be put off by that. In regular Sanskrit, it won't be there. In the conventional Sanskrit, it won't be there. Only in Vedic Sanskrit, that the dirgham is there. So, that way you understand. Now you can understand those vakyas. So, yaha apanena apaniti. Apaniti means apaniti. So, apana is inhalation. So, there is a vital force sitting here. It is like a shift. So, one vital force expels and keeps quiet. Then the other vital force comes forth and draws in. That vital force is called apana. Now the point is apana independent and self-sufficient in its function? No. Then by which it is acting? By atma it is acting. Okay? Then udana. Udana means a point comes, a time comes when the vital force, which is fivefold in this body, leaves this body. Udana. It need not come then only. It could be there in the life also, during life also. All the time we need not go to death. Udana will be functional at death, all right? But during life also, udana will function. You see, suppose there is a nausea and a vomiting. One vomits, that is udana. Vomiting is always udana. And then you yawn, you know. Like that yawning is there. That is udana. After sleep. And then you sneeze out. That is udana. So anything forcibly coming out is udana. So at the time of death, the same thing happens in a different way. In a bigger way. But till then also Udana is there. This Udana is there, the function of Udana. So main thing is Pranapana. But other things are also mentioned. Because there are five. One should not understand, imagine, because people could imagine anything. So Pranapana are caused by Atma, but Udana is caused by something else. So that kind of a confusion may not be there. Udana is also caused by the vital force called Udana. Vomiting, etc., caused by the vital force called Udana. Now the question is Udana self-sufficient and independent? No. It is doing its job because of the Atma. By Atma it is doing. Okay. Then one more thing is there. Vyana. You know what is Vyana? The gap between Prana and Apana is Vyana. That gap. You examine it. You lift a weight. I will ask you a question, you tell me. While lifting the weight, do you inhale or exhale? You neither inhale nor exhale. That is the correct answer. That is Vyana. You neither inhale nor exhale. Generally, when you have to exert a lot, either pushing a heavy weight or lifting a heavy weight, so at that time it is called Balavat Karma. A karma which demands a lot of energy, lot of power. So during that action, the inhalation-exhalation process stops. And then you do it. That's why these weightlifters, you know what they do? So, after exhaling, you should not lift weight. That is not proper. You inhale and hold it back and lift. Like that. That is how they do. Did you ever see them? They inhale and lift. And hold it and then lift. Not while inhaling. So, while inhaling, the energy will be distributed. Energy should not be distributed that way. Inhaled and then lift. That is Vyana. So Balavat Karma. This Vyana is a function. It's a power. And this power, is it independent self-sufficient? No. There is Vyana, the action of Vyana, by which power, by which source? That source is Atma. Sarvaha कार्यकरण संघातगताः प्राणनादि चेष्टाः दारुयंत्रस्येव येन क्रियन्ते. सो शंकर टॉक्स ऑफ ए दारुयंत्र. दारुयंत्र मीन्स ए मशीन मेड ऑफ वुड. दारुयंत्र दि यंत्र इज लाइक दिस. दिस मशीन इज देयर. And it has many levers and many wheels and all kinds of things are present in it. It is designed in a very elaborate way. And then what happens is you put some item above. Suppose you put this paddy into it on the top. Then this yantra is moving. All levers are moving, wheels are rotating, something is happening. All kinds of movements are there in the yantra. And then from one side, you will get rice. From the other side, you will get husk. From the third side, you get bran. This is how it is happening. This is the Daru yantra. You see, there is a yantra. This donut yantra is there. So this yantra, what it is doing, we don't know. So they put the flour on one side and the sugar and other things on the, so in different baskets, they are allotted baskets, 2-3, and put everything in that. And then stand aside. And from one side donuts will come, from the other side holes will come. Donut holes will come. So something is happening within the yantra. So some oil is getting heated, everything is happening. This is the donut yantra. So like Daru yantra. Now this Daru Yantra's secret, what is it? This one lever is there. That lever, it protrudes into the behind the screen. And behind the screen, somebody is sitting there and he is employed for that purpose. He is rotating it. And you don't see him. Only Daru Yantra working, you see. He is rotating. Now, look at this Daru Yantra. This wheel is thrashing. Now, is it independent or is it dependent upon something else? It is dependent upon something else. That something else is sitting behind the screen. Daru yantrasyeva. So there is prana, there is prana, there is apana, there is vyana, there is udana. Oh my God, all these things are there. This is the daru yantra. Daru bhuto murarihi. So, murari has become daru. Daru means wood. In Puri Jagannath, Murari means Vishnu. He is the daru there. Daru means wood. Anyway, this is the daru. Daru, you know. Because it is wood. That's why they keep this in the wood. When the child is born, they keep it in the wood made of cradle. And as the person grows, he takes the help of the wood in the form of a staff. Wooden staff he carries to support him. And then when the person leaves, again wood will be there. Daru will be there. Means he is burnt to ashes using daru, wood. And when the person marries in old days, he used to be shown around in a palanquin, which is again wood. So this way, when he learns in childhood, when he learns walking, there is a wooden three-wheeler made of wood, and he uses that and learns walking. Like this, this person is born into wood and he lives by wood and he dies into wood. He is wood all the way. This is how one poet Kabir described it. Anyway, this is the Daru Yantra, really speaking. There is no other Daru Yantra. This is the Daru Yantra, like Donut Yantra. So, it is electricity which is the Atma of every movement there. All movements. Only difference is, there it is power and material, both are independently existing. Whereas here, there is no such thing. One kosha resolves into the other kosha, because all the koshas are shadows. That difference is always there. So, because you see, when you give an illustration, there must be some difference. Without difference, the simile cannot work. Simile, if this is same as that, can you compare moon with moon? Can you compare face? Her face is like her face. It is not simile. Her face is like moon, Mukhan Chandra Iva. That is simile. So that's why you should not stretch the simile to the last extent. Just take the small part where the coexist, where the similarity is there, that alone you should take. So Daru Yantra. In the Daru Yantra, all functions are there, but they are all caused by an unseen power. Similarly here, pranapana, vyanodana, samana, they are all caused by the Atma. Like that he tells Atma. He doesn't tell Atma in real terms. What is Atma? This is Atma. Idamittham Atma. That way he doesn't tell. Anyway. Sarvaha karyakarana sanghata gata prananadi cheshtaha. In this Daru Yantra, in this upadhi, or the conglomerate of the five elements, there are so many actions, so many movements, cheshta, like inhaling, exhaling, etc. These all owe their power to that Atma. Yena kriyante. In a way, it is the Atma which is doing all these things. I mean, which is making it possible. That is the idea. Nahi chetana vadanadhishthitasya Daru yantrasyeva prananadi cheshta vidyante. Suppose this sanghata is there, this conglomerate. It is like Daru Yantra, the machine made of wood, wooden machine. So, this Daru Yantra, it is powered by a person, a living person. Not seen, sitting behind the screen, he is powering it. Suppose he stopped powering it. He was tired of doing it, he went for a cup of coffee from that side. Then what happens to this Daru Yantra? It stops functioning. Therefore, chetanavat anadhishthitasya. a living person, sometimes a bullock, etc., will be drawing this Daru Yantra, will be making it move. Not necessarily a person. A bullock, a beast can move it also. Doesn't matter. So Chetanavat, a living person or a living being, an animal or a human being, has to put his power into this Daru Yantra. Suppose it is not there, anadhishthitasya, the connection is broken. Then for this body, like Daru Yantra, no movements will be there. Prananadi cheshtahana vidyante. Therefore, so all these cheshtas owe their origin to that source, and that source is the Atma. You see, people understand doing easily, because doing you can see with the eyes. Knowing, doing is visible for the eyes, it is very gross. But knowing is more subtle than doing. And being is the subtlest of all. And Atma is the being, which is knowing. And that being knowing is the source of doing. That way you can put it. तस्मात् विज्ञानमयेन अधिष्ठितं विलक्षणेन दारुयंत्रवत् प्राणनादिचेष्टां प्रतिपद्यते. इसि विज्ञानमयेन, आत्मा विज्ञानमयः मीन्स् विज्ञानोपाधिकः इत्यर्थः. This also you should carefully understand. There is vijnana. Vijnana, the explanation for the word vijnana, you see, vijnana means differentiated knowingness. That is vijnana. Suppose you see forms, knowledge of forms, knowledge of sounds, knowledge of smells, knowledge of tastes, knowledge of senses of touch, hard, soft, cool, hot, etc. Each is a knowledge. And how many knowledges are there? Five categories of knowledge. And each category has millions of pulses of knowledge, right? Pulsations of knowledge. Because knowledge of forms means it is knowledge of the flower, knowledge of the clock, knowledge of the book, knowledge. These are all forms only. How many forms are there? Countless. And how many sounds are there? Countless. So this vijnana, the differentiated knowingness, it has millions and millions of pulsations, right? And these pulsations, they are not static. They are in movement all the time. It is a flow, continuous flow. The entire waking state is constituted by continuous flow of the pulsations of knowledge. And now five sense organ perceptions I told, then feelings are there. Feeling is a movement of mind. Suppose I started feeling sad. I need time to feel sad. In an instant I cannot become sad. So now I started becoming sad. 5 minutes, 10 minutes, or 1 hour, or one day, I will be sad. You need time. Without time you cannot be sad. That's why when you abide in the timeless state, there will be no sadness. You need time to be sad. So, that's why now there is no time means even to become sad, one needs time. So, it is a movement in time. To be happy, movement in time. So, all feelings are movements in times. Time, thoughts are movement in time. So, ego is also a thought. It is a movement in time. So, it's a flow. So, let us give a name to it in English. So, flow of differentiated knowingness, you can call it. Okay? I would like to call this way, flow of manifest consciousness. Because the word conscious is used like that. Conscious. Are you conscious of the latest developments? Yeah, in Iraq? Yes, I am conscious of the latest developments in Iraq. So, manifest consciousness. So, I am saying manifest because sometimes the word consciousness could be applied to the unmanifest also. Possible. There are such usages. Usage is what? You use it with an intent and you explain what you use over. సో ది వర్డ్ కాన్షియస్నెస్ కుడ్ బి యూజ్డ్ టు ది అన్మానిఫెస్ట్ ఇన్ విచ్ కేస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ది మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ ది ఆత్మ యూ కెన్ యూజ్ ఇట్ దట్ వే ఆర్ యూ కెన్ యూజ్ ఇట్ విత్ ఎన్ ఎడ్జెక్టివ్ మేనిఫెస్ట్ కాన్షియస్నెస్ దట్ ఈస్ విజ్ఞానమయ నౌ దిస్ ఫ్లో ఆఫ్ కాన్షియస్నెస్ మేనిఫెస్ట్ ఐ మీన్ మేనిఫెస్ట్ యూ టేక్ ఇట్ లైక్ దట్ వెన్ ఐ సే ఫ్లో ఆఫ్ కాన్షియస్నెస్ డోంట్ సే ఫ్లో ఆఫ్ ఆత్మ ఫ్లో ఆఫ్ మేనిఫెస్ట్ కాన్షియస్నెస్ So this flow of manifest consciousness is like flow of a river. Now, what is the content of the flow of river? Water. Can you have flow of river without water? No. In every part of that flow, flow is a wave or whatever, every part of the flow of river is soaked in what? Is soaked in water. So now, what is a river? In the form of a river, what is it that you get? What is it that you get in the form of a river? Water. So now what is this river for water? River is upadhi for water. You got the meaning of it? Similarly, this manifest consciousness is the upadhi through which that atma is expressing itself. That is how it is. So that is called vijnanamayaha. That is the meaning of the word vijnanamayaha. And the person we call person, purushaha, the individual, vijnanamayaha purushaha. The individual is nothing but a continuous flow of manifest consciousness. That's why when this flow ends, the person also ends. You go to sleep. Now sleeping, still flow is lingering. And now the flow stopped and you are not there anymore. You just don't exist after that. Because the flow is not there. Because the idea of a person is also part of that flow. So that is vijnanamayaha. So that vijnanamayaha, vijnanamayena adhishthitam. So atma as manifest consciousness, that is already first stage. It already manifested. And as the manifest consciousness, it is the source of all this doing. I told you, being to knowing, knowing to doing. And daruyantravat prananadi cheshtam pratipadyate. The being manifests as the knowing, and the knowing further manifests as the doing. It is like this. I tell you an example. Gasoline is there. They call it gas here. Sometimes the word gas could be misleading. Before coming to America, I was thinking that they use gas to run their vehicles in America, like they do in India. In Delhi, they use gas, natural petroleum gas they use to run buses and autos and all that. So I thought, to reduce pollution. In certain respects, India is more advanced than America in some of these things, in some areas. Hybrid vehicles, etc. Those people come out with wonderful innovations. They don't care for patents, this and that. Just go on doing it. That's all. And suddenly, I am traveling in a car. And the person told me, Swamiji, this car doesn't use petrol. Do you know that? I said, I don't know. No, it is going so smoothly. Some old-fashioned car. So he changed the engine and put a gas cylinder. That like that they run. Anyway, so the point is, so the word gas means, I used to think that they run by gas. It is not gas, it is gasoline. So now petrol is there. The petrol, suppose you do not put petrol into the car. Car is very beautiful, upholstery, this, that, all kinds of alankaras are there. Inside some very beautiful alankaras are there. All kinds of things are there. Very beautiful. Even the tires are adorned with the covers and all that. So very beautiful. Suppose you don't put petrol in it. Then will it run? It won't run. Now you have put petrol. Now what is this petrol? Suppose it is now running. It is running. It is heating. You can see a movie also inside the car using the same power of the petrol. So now it is the petrol which is making every wheel turn and even the steering is power steering. So it is the power of the petrol which is making all these functions possible. And that petrol is sitting inside, not to be seen. like that daruyantravat prananadi cheshtam pratipadyate. You see, the petrol as such won't run the car. The petrol manifests as the piston power and runs the car. And the further manifests as electricity, as the wheels rotate, a battery is charged. So petrol to piston power to all these functions. Similarly, Atma to knowing, the power of knowing, Vijnanamaya, and from there all actions. That is how it is happening. And so, only difference is, in the case of Daru Yantra, or a car, you can take out that petrol and put it in a small bottle and show, this is the source of all power, like that you can show. That liquid you can show. Whereas in the case of Atma, that liquid-like thing, you cannot show anything here. That is the only difference. And also, in the case of car, petrol, the wheels, and the dome, etc., everything have the same order of reality in the example. Whereas in the Darshtantika, the situation is different. The body, etc., are the shadows, and the power is an appearance, and the source is the only reality. That kind of difference is there. But then, differences must be there between the example and the original. There must be some difference. Tasmat sosti karyakarana sanghata vilakshanaha yascheshtayati. You see, we started with a question. Astiva nava. Atma, the essential reality of the individual, haiya nahi, astiva nava. Is it there or not there? Because not there is a school of thought. So now we have concluded, asti, yaprānena prāniti, yopānena pāniti, yaudānena udāniti, asti. It is there. And number one conclusion, asti. Okay. If it is asti, then Atma is the body? No. Atma is not the body. Karyakarana sanghata vilakshanaha. Is electricity the bulb? Is electricity the machine? No. It is always distinct from the sanghata. Therefore, Atma makes all the functions of life possible. But Atma is not the functions of life. Atma makes mind possible, mind capable of thinking. But Atma is not the mind. Atma makes body alive, but Atma is not the body. Karyakarana sanghata vilakshanaha, always distinct. Yet, cheshtayati, it makes the sanghata move, but it is distinct from the sanghata. Viveka, always viveka, viveka pradhana. Shastram is viveka pradhana. Because, you know, it cannot describe the vastu in real terms. It can only point out the vastu. And every time you point out, viveka works. Shakha Chandra Nyayam. Look at that shakha. Shakha means branch. The moon has to be shown. So there is a Y kind of branch. The moon is above the tree. And the tree has a Y kind of branch. So look through the middle of those two branches. Shakhayoh Madhye, look through that Y of the two branches. Do you see the two branches? Yes, of course I see the two branches. Okay, then he is about to say something. Then already this person concluded, oh, the moon is the two branches. No, not like that. Then you see through the two branches. I see something in the sky. That is the moon. Oh, moon is that which seen through the two branches. Hare bhai, not. Drop the two branches. Forget about the two branches. So this is called Shakha Chandra Nyayam. Therefore, viveka, you can only point out like that. Therefore, through body, through mind, through prana, we point out the Atma. Atma is distinct from all these things. And so Atma is none of these. But Atma is distinct from them. That is, the Shastra can go up to that point. Once you know Atma, you will understand that nothing exists outside Atma. All being is Atma. therefore what is there outside Atma? Nothing is there. So we concluded the first mantra. Mantras are only two, but the discussion is there. We'll continue. Purnamada, Purnamidam, Purnat, Purnamudachyate, Purnasya, Purnamadaya, Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Harihi Om Tatsat. Shri Krishna, Paramastu.